So today's turn we will study chemistry. Where is chemistry? Yeah, here it is. And also that there are many chapters as you are seeing on your screen. State of matter, solubility, particles and mixture, atomic number, mass number, isotopes, formula mass, mole calculation, all that. Ionic reaction, testing, hydrogen, alkane, alcohol, pH value, indicator.
Yes, we're doing acid alkalizing, so.
Where is there?
If you go up, it says acid alkalizing set. The pH scale, the indicator.
It's a pH scale and indicator. Okay. Yeah. So let's start this one. So first one is your indicator, beta. Always remember indicator means when an acid is dissolved in water, we get an acidic solution. Okay.
Okay.
When an acid is dissolved in water, we get acidic solution. Okay.
Okay.
Means, you can understand in this. Suppose that an acid you can take like vinegar. Okay. So just take a little bit amount of vinegar, and if you would like to dissolve that in water, then whatever solution that you will get as a result, that will be your acidic solution. Clear?
Okay.
When a base dissolve in water, then it is water. So as usual, we know that is an alkali, so it will make an alkaline solution. Okay, alkaline solution. Okay, a basic solution, you can say that. Okay, so first one we have to understand a little bit what is acid. Okay, acid are the substances. Fundamental definition is that acid are the substances which when dissolve in water gives hydronium ion. Are the substances which when dissolved in water gives hydronium ion. I think in your previous class I explained that to you, huh?
Yeah.
And bases are the substances which when dissolved in water gives hydroxyl ion. And also beta, here with respect to indicator, they are saying that acid are the corrosive substance which have pH value less than 7. pH value less than 7, acidity is a cause by a high concentration of hydrogen ion. Acidity they are talking about. Suppose that if on any particular day, we suppose that few days before that there was Eid, okay, I think that your mom had prepared a little bit delicious food, okay, on that day. So suppose that in normal days that you generally used to eat at least 3 or 4 chapatis, okay? But on that day, that because that there was Eid, okay? So on that specific day, as usual, your religious festival was that. So I think different type of delicious food that your mom had prepared. So you suppose that you would like to take a little bit, you had eaten a little bit more food. That means a maximum number of chapatis. That means in normal days you generally used to eat at least 2 or 3, but on that day you generally used to eat 4 or 5. So that means in that condition, and regarding to that, in normal days, suppose that when you are eating 2 or 3 chapatis, then there becomes 100 ml of HCl that would like to secrete when your food would like to come into your stomach. Clear?
Okay.
But suppose that on your Eid, you had eaten 4 or 5 chapatis. So regarding to that, when that food will come, when you will swallow the food, then that when that food will come in your stomach, then first time that your stomach would like to secrete 100 ml of HCl. Okay.
Okay.
And that 100 ml of HCl, that is sufficient for digestion of 2 or 3 chapatis. Then there will be undigested number of chapatis will be 2. Okay, then after few time, there will again a there will again a secretion of HCl, 100 ml of HCl that will again secrete into your stomach. Okay, now this time 100 ml of HCl that is not suitable, that is much in quantity for two chapatis. Okay, in that condition there will be a little bit, means two chapati that will digest, and after then a little bit amount of acid that will remain in your stomach or not.
Yeah,
then you will feel a type of acidity. Okay,
yeah,
means indirectly, in fundamentally you can understand that when there will be excess amount of HCl that would like to secrete into your stomach, then you feel acidity. Okay,
okay.
How? Because what does it mean? It means that at particular random time the number of hydronium ion that will be maximum, number of hydronium ion or hydrogen ion that will be maximum in your stomach. Okay, that's why you are feeling acidity. Okay, or there will be a little bit of means sweet stomach ache that start to. Okay,
okay,
clear?
Yeah.
So always remember that acid pH value, pH, so pH value they are talking about, pH is the type of scale which contains from number 0 to 14. Okay,
okay,
and 0 to 6 that will be pH value less than 7, that will be your acid. Okay,
okay,
or I am repeating again, the substances having pH value less than 7, that is your acid.
Yeah,
and pH value equals to 7, that will be your neutral. Okay, neither acid nor basic. Okay,
okay,
neither acidic nor basic, and yeah, the third one, that is your base. So basic substance will be, base will be that one whose pH value that will be greater than 7 but less than 14. Okay, or equals to 14. Understand?
Yeah.
Yes, and if a solution, and you can see that clearly, it is also written here what I explained just before. If a solution is neither acid nor alkaline, okay, alkaline, that means basic in nature, you can understand also there. Okay,
yeah,
that becomes neutral, means if a substance that is given to you in laboratory that is neither acidic nor basic, so that will be your neutral solution. Okay,
yeah.
Always remember that pure water is neutral. Okay,
yeah,
that is paraffins. Okay, that is, so it is paraffins. So now what is your paraffin? A liquid fraction from crude oil, also called kerosene, and containing alkalis, alkanes, saturated hydrocarbon. Okay,
okay.
Paraffins, that means a liquid fraction from crude oil, also contain, also called kerosene. Kerosene oil, I think you know about that, which we generally used in stoves. Okay,
yeah,
yeah. So kerosene oil, it is a type of liquid fraction, okay, from a crude oil, okay, and contains alkanes, okay, saturated hydrocarbon.
Okay.
Now one more important thing, that what is hydrocarbon? When a hydrogen, when a hydrogen and chlorine, when hydrogen and chlorine, okay, sorry, hydrogen and means carbon, they will combine together. Sorry, I was talking to my child, that's why a little bit I distracted. So hydrocarbon, by its name you can clearly understand that, what this one, hydrocarbon. Hydrocarbon, that means hydrogen plus carbon, yeah, that will make hydrocarbon. Simple example, that is your methane, CH4, okay?
Okay.
CH4, and they are saying that saturated hydrocarbon. Saturated hydrocarbon, that means they are single bonded hydrocarbon, okay?
Okay.
There are, means fundamentally I am explaining that to you, beta, because that your class is recording, so many times that you can revise that. That's why I am explaining that to you again and again. Saturated hydrocarbon, that means so when hydrogen will combine to carbon will form hydrocarbon. Clear?
Okay.
Simple example you can take, like methane, CH4. Okay?
Okay.
And also, there are two types of hydrocarbon. First one is saturated hydrocarbon. Second one is your unsaturated hydrocarbon. Saturated hydrocarbon, there will be alkanes. Okay?
Okay.
Wait. Give me a second. I am explaining that in written. Hold on. Don't worry, I will make you perfect, beta. So, just see on your screen, I am going to explain you a little bit over here. Yes, just see that. Okay, so, first one, hydrocarbon. I'm writing here, give me a second. And you'll understand very clearly. Hydrocarbon, okay. Hydrocarbon. That means what? It is hydrogen plus carbon. Okay, that is your hydrocarbon. And it is of two type. It is of two type. First one is saturated. Saturated. And second one is your unsaturated, okay? Unsaturated, okay? Saturated hydrocarbon always becomes alkanes, okay?
Okay.
Alkane. And always there will be bond, single bonded, okay? Alkanes, they are single bonded. Single bond. Bonded, okay? Or if it means bonded, I can write down in downwards so that a little bit. Single and bonded. Clear?
Yeah.
Single bonded. And now, unsaturated. In unsaturated, beta, there becomes two. In unsaturated, there becomes two. First one, your is alkene. In two, and in two, there are, it is of two type, okay? First one is alkene.
Okay.
Alkene, I am writing, okay? Second one is your alkyne, okay? Alkyne, A-L-K-Y-N-E, alkyne, give me a second, sorry, a little bit easy way to understand that I have to write A-L-K-Y-N-E, alkyne, beta, alkene, alkene will be your double bond, okay?
Okay.
Double bond. Double bond, clear? And alkyne, that will be your triple bond, okay?
Okay.
Understand?
Ooh.
So, up to here, that fundamentally that you have to understand that hydrocarbon, that means hydrogen plus carbon, that will give you hydrocarbon. There are two fundamentally hydrocarbons are, okay, saturated hydrocarbon and unsaturated. Saturated hydrocarbon, they are known as alkanes. They are always single bonded, okay? They are always single bonded. Only one bond will be, okay? That means, single bonded means bond between hydrogen and carbon, that will be your single bond, okay?
Okay.
Like you can see that on your right hand side. I am taking example of like CH4, okay? You can see that C, single bond H. It is your methane. Methane. Yes. It is your alkane. Okay? You can understand?
Yeah.
And next one that will be your alkene, huh? So alkene, alkene you can see that C2H4, it is your alkene. So alkene, that means C will be here, C will be here, okay. H will be here, H will be here, and H will be here, and H will be here. I am right, I am drawing a structure, and there will be double bond here, okay, beta. Understand? Here you can see that carbon and hydrogen all contain single bond, but here you can see that they are double bond, okay. Carbon and carbon in between there is double bond, that's why it is your means ethene. Ethene. And now the third one is alkyne. So C2H2, okay. So C2H2, two carbon will be there and two hydrogen will be there, and there will be triple bond, okay.
Okay,
understand? It is your ethyne, YNE, okay. By its suffix, okay. Wait a second, because here you can see that your suffix is N, that's why it is known as alkane, single bond. Just see on your screen.
Yeah, I can see.
Here you can see that alkene, that's why it is your alkene, ene, ethene, okay, ene. And here is your ene, that's why it is triple bond. Understand?
Yeah.
Single bond, it is your double bond, okay, and it is your triple bond. Clear?
Okay.
Yes. So, how many times you would like to revise? That is depend on you. Okay. So now, next you can see that. And now indicators. Indicators are the substances that change the color when they are added to acid or alkaline solution. Okay.
Okay.
Means indicators are those substances which would like to tell you that either your given substance in your laboratory, that is acid or base. Means suppose that you can consider a reaction, consider a incidence. Suppose that you are in laboratory and then your teacher would like to, your chemistry teacher would like to give you a solution, okay. Then if he or she will ask you that what is that, that means he is or she is asking about either the substance is acidic or basic, okay. Then you will use indicator to identify that either the given substance is your acid or base. Clear?
Okay.
Do you understand that?
Yeah.
Again, I am repeating, if your teacher will give you, if your chemistry teacher will give you a substance or a solution, and then if he or she will ask you that what is that type of solution, so in that condition you will use indicator to determine that either your given solution, that is acidic or basic, I mean that is acid or base. Clear?
Yeah.
Indicators are of many type, okay. Clearly you can understand that, okay. Litmus paper, litmus phenolphthalein and methyl orange, okay, they are your common indicator, okay. Very important. Some type of question like your teacher would like to ask you in your test that write down the name of two indicators, so you can write there litmus phenolphthalein or phenolphthalein methyl orange, okay, or methyl orange or litmus, okay. They all are indicator which are, that are commonly used in laboratory. So that means you have to learn this one, okay?
Okay.
Clear?
Yeah.
Now, first one is your litmus. Litmus indicator solution turns red to red in acidic solution, okay? So that means litmus is, litmus indicator solution, litmus indicator solution turned red in acidic solution, okay.
Okay,
that means if there is a litmus paper and if that will turn into red, okay.
Okay,
okay, That means litmus paper turn means blue to red. Okay. Blue to red. Litmus, firstly, blue to red, and red to blue. Wait, I am writing there. Give me a second. Blue to red, and red to blue. Okay. So two type of litmus. So litmus is one, but when that will change from blue to red, that means your solution is acidic. Okay.
Okay.
Acidic. Yes. And when your litmus paper will change from red to blue, here will be blue. Give me a second. Blue. So that means it will be your red to blue, that is your basic. Okay. Clear?
Okay.
Do you understand that? So litmus indicator solution turns red in acidic solution. Okay.
Okay.
Blue in basic solution. And purple in neutral solution. My God, very important, very, very important thing that they are writing here. It is the litmus indicator solution turn red in acidic solution, blue in basic solution, and purple in neutral solution. Oh my God, very important thing, beta. Okay, just to read. Means just revise your today's class two or three times. Okay. Yes, I will update that within few hours, within 1 hour. Okay, I will upload that on my channel. Okay. So firstly you have to go and see that and like and subscribe. I think subscribe that, you subscribe that. Okay, and please beta, it's my request. I think that you have friends, there are many friends of yours. Okay.
Yeah.
So you can tell them about my channel so that they can also get, if they are not able to reach me. So in that way, that means they are not able to contact me. In that condition, they can go to my channel. They can see my videos. Okay. Related to the topic which they want to understand. Okay. So it is very important. That's why here I'm marking a star. So it will be much convenient for you that when you will see this video, then you can make a note over there that what is important. Okay. Understand? Okay.
Yeah.
Yes. So litmus paper comes as red litmus paper and blue litmus paper. Okay.
Yeah.
There are two type of litmus paper. First one is red litmus paper and blue litmus paper. Okay.
Yeah.
And if your solution is given, you are using red litmus paper. So if red litmus paper turned blue, then that is your basic solution. And if you are using blue litmus paper and that turns red, then that is acidic solution. Okay.
Okay.
Yes. So a table that you are seeing here. Okay. A table you are seeing. If you are taking red litmus paper, okay?
Yeah.
Okay. Red litmus paper, then that will red. Okay. If that is acidic solution. Okay. If you had taken red litmus paper and you are dipping that into solution, and if that will remains red, that means that will be your acidic solution. Okay.
Okay.
Yes. And if you are dipping into your solution and again that's stay red, that means that is your neutral also. Okay, that means not affecting. Okay.
Yeah.
And if your red litmus paper turns blue, okay, so that is your alkaline. Just see that I also wrote here basic.
Yeah.
Okay, here you can see that if you are dipping red litmus paper into given solution, and if that is changing into blue in color. Okay, so that is your basic solution which your teacher gave you. Okay,
sir.
Yeah.
I'm just asking you a question.
Yeah.
Since water is neutral, so say if a substance is neutral, so is it drinkable?
Neutral.
Yeah.
A little bit you can drink that, okay? Either neither acidic nor basic, you can drink that, okay? But for your kind information, beta, just before I explain that to you, that if any solution that is neither acidic nor basic, so that will be neutral, okay? Pure water, that will always be neutral in nature, okay?
Yeah.
So it is not possible for us to drink pure water, Shyam, you know.
Okay.
We can't drink pure water. Pure water, okay. That means there will be, it will contains no ions, okay? Will be no ions, okay?
Okay.
Yeah, I'm writing one thing here, so just for your learning. Pure water. Water. Cannot drink. We cannot drink pure water, okay? Why? Because having no iron, okay? No ions. Clear?
Yeah.
And also, if you had taken blue litmus paper like this one, so if blue litmus paper turns red, then that solution your acid, okay?
Okay.
And if that will stay blue, that means your given solution will be either neutral or either alkaline. Okay.
Okay.
Understand?
Yeah.
Means simple, you have to understand that if you are taking blue litmus paper, if that is changing into red, then the solution is acidic. Okay. If it is not changing into red, and it stays blue, so your given solution, either that will be neutral or that will be acidic. Okay?
Okay.
Understand?
Yeah.
Means basic, sorry. Basic. Either neutral or basic, if that is blue litmus paper. And if that is a red litmus paper, so red litmus paper and you are dipping that in a solution, so either red will be red. So that means that will be means acidic, or either that will be basic. Okay, understand?
Yeah.
Clear?
Yes.
Great. Yes. Acid turn blue litmus paper red. Just see. Acid turn blue litmus paper red, and base turn red litmus paper blue. Are you seeing that?
Yes.
Yes. There are some other indicators. Okay. So as I explained that to you, that there are three fundamental indicators are. First one is your litmus paper. Second one is your phenolphthalein. And the third one is your methyl orange. Okay.
Yeah.
So suppose that if you are using methyl orange, so if you will add a little bit amount of methyl orange in your given solution, okay?
So what's methyl orange?
Methyl orange is your indicator, beta, okay? It's the name of indicator.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay, first indicator was your litmus, okay?
Litmus.
It was your first indicator. First indicator, that is litmus. So second and third indicator, yeah, it is your second one, it is your third one. By different color that you will understand that about their specific characteristic. So methyl orange, okay, you can understand in this way. If we add methyl methyl orange in a given solution, okay? Given solution. If we add methyl orange in given solution and solution turns red, okay, and solution turn red, wait a little bit different color, yeah, solution turns red. So what does it mean? That is solution will be what? Solution will be acidic, okay?
Okay.
Yes, that will be acidic. Clear, beta?
Yes.
Again, I'm repeating. If we add methyl orange in given solution, which your teacher will give you in your laboratory, and the solution turns red, so that means whatever solution that your teacher gave to you, that is your acidic, okay? Or that is your acid. Understand?
Yeah.
Now, another is that if we add methyl orange in given solution, solution and solution turn and the solution turn yellow, okay, solution turn yellow, okay?
Okay.
That means then it will be base, okay? Then it will be base, okay? Or alkaline. Understand? Yes. Alkaline. Clear?
Yeah.
And next indicator, third one, that is your phenolphthalein. So phenolphthalein, if you will add phenolphthalein indicator in your solution, and if the color will disappear, then that is your acidic or neutral, okay? But if that will be pink, if your solution will convert into pink in color, then that will be your basic, okay?
Yeah.
You understand that?
Yeah.
Again, I am repeating, bete. Suppose you are given phenolphthalein, okay? So, and also solution is given. So, when you will add phenolphthalein in your solution, and if solution will be colorless, so either that will be acidic or neutral, and if its color will change into pink, then that will be basic in nature, okay?
Okay.
You understand that clearly?
Yeah.
Great. Let me change the page. Oh, okay, sorry. I had to refresh that. Yeah, it's coming. Shan, are you understanding that, beta?
Yes.
Yeah, let's come to the next page. Yes. Now, next is your pH scale. pH scale, as I explained that to you just a few minutes before, that if whatever your substance is given, either you have to consider that your given substance is your acidic, basic or neutral. Okay, then a little bit that you have to find the its characteristic. So generally pH scale is used to measure acidity and basicity of given solution. Okay, that means either your given solution is acid or base, okay, that you can consider with the help of pH scale. Clear?
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah. So we can understand that chemical properties of many solutions enable them to be divided into three categories: acidic, basic or neutral. Beta, here basic, that means alkaline. Don't be confused in alkaline and basic. They are the same thing, alkaline and basic. Okay?
Okay.
And always remember that substances which have less pH value less than 7, you can see that up to light green, from 0 to 6, if the pH value that is 0 to 6, then that will be your acid, okay? If your pH value that is your 7, so that will be your neutral, okay? And if substance pH value that will be greater than 7 and up to 14, okay, then that will be basic in nature. Clear?
Good.
Understand?
Yeah.
Great. And yeah, this one that you have to understand, beta, means learn, not of understand, because you understand that solution with pH less than 7 is acidic, solution with pH equals to 7, that is neutral, and solution with a pH greater than 7 are alkaline. Okay?
Okay.
Clear?
Yeah.
Now, if a universal indicator is added to a solution, okay? So all these type of indicators that I explained that to you, now there is also one specific type of indicator, that is your universal indicator, okay?
Okay.
Yeah. So it is the type of indicator which changes the color that shows the pH value of the solution.
Oh, okay? Yeah, we did that in school once.
Yes, universal indicator is the mixture of a variety of other indicators and can be used to measure the approximate pH value of the solution. So you have to learn this one. What I underlined here, universal indicator is a mixture of a variety of the indicator and which can be obtained with a pH probes. Okay? Understand?
Okay.
So here, beta, you are seeing that less than 7, that will be your acidic, greater than 7 and less than 14, that is your base. And okay, the pH value of 7, that is your neutral, means neither acidic nor basic.
Okay.
Clear, beta?
Yeah.
Good. Now come to the third page. Only the method is that you can revise all these what I am explaining that to you again and again in order to be perfect, okay? Or just to get your efficiency. Next is your acid and alkalis. Okay, acid, as usual you know that when a atom or group of atoms lose electron, okay?
Okay.
I mean, suppose that there is an element, okay? Suppose that there is an element. If that element is losing electrons, okay? Then it will convert into ions or not?
Yeah.
Yes. You can understand in this way. Suppose that there, you can take example of sodium. Sodium electronic configuration. Wait, hold on. I am explaining that to you. beta, yes, acid and alkali is with respect to transferring or receiving or donating electrons. Just see. The losing of electrons will make a cation,
okay?
Yeah, cations or electropositive, okay? And next one is gaining of electrons will form anions, okay? Anion, A-N-I-O-N, that will be anion, clear?
Yeah.
Yes, so fundamentally you can understand that either your given solution that will be acid, so it will lose electron, okay? Understand, beta?
Yeah.
And if your given solution is basic, then it will accept electron. Clear?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, next is yes, so for example, yeah, you can see that when acid dissolve in water, okay, ions can be either positively or negatively charged. Yes, I explained that to you. I explained that when it will positive, when it will negative, okay, the losing of electron that will make cation, that is positive charge, okay, and gaining of electron will form an ion, that is negative charge, okay? So these two points that you have to understand in order to clear analyzing or clear understanding of your acid and base, okay?
Okay.
Yes, also here you can see that there is acid, they are explaining over here also. First of all, atoms also you can understand there. Yeah, atom, can you tell me what is atom? Atoms are the simplest particle, okay? I am writing definition over here. Atoms are simplest particles which are dependent in nature, okay? Dependent in nature, okay?
Yeah.
Nature and take part in any chemical reaction, okay? Clear?
Yeah.
So dependent is very important, that's why which are particles which are dependent in nature, that is your very important. Okay, so that's why they are known as atom. Now come to your acids. Okay, so acid, that means when acid means I told you definition that when we started, firstly I told you miss whatever definition I learned there, that acid are the substances which when dissolve in water gives hydrogen ion. Okay. Acid are the substances which when dissolve in water gives hydrogen ion or hydronium ion. So these hydrogen ions sometimes called protons. Okay.
Okay.
Yes. Because you know that number of proton that is equals to in an atom. Wait. You also have to learn that. Why they are saying that proton, and these are sometimes called proton, but normally they are known as electron. Okay. So why electron and proton are same? So that means you have to learn that in an atom, it is important. All that whatever I am writing on screen, that is very important. Okay. In an atom, okay, number of proton equals to number of electron. Okay. That's why they are saying that these are also known as proton. Okay.
Okay.
Fundamentally, you can understand that in a hydrogen, there becomes one electron in the outermost shell. Okay. In hydrogen, it is your hydrogen. There becomes only one electron in the outermost shell. Okay.
Okay.
One electron. I'm saying that number of electron that is equals to number of proton. So proton that will be inside the nucleus. So one proton will be also there. Okay. Clear?
Okay.
Remember one thing. Remember, proton and neutron, okay? Neutron, okay? Proton and neutron always exist, okay? Always exist in nucleus. Okay.
Okay.
Yes. In nucleus. 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 Okay. That's why they are called that's why they are called nucleons. Okay. NUCLEONS. Nucleons. Okay.
Okay.
Understand? And always, yeah. Electron revolve around the nucleus. Revolve around the nucleus. Okay.
Okay.
Clear, beta?
Yeah.
All these you have to learn, beta, okay?
Okay.
Suppose that one example they are taking here. SCL. Aqueous SCL. Why it is known as aqueous? Aqueous means which can dissolve in water, okay? Aqueous, that means which can dissolve in water. So as usual, we know that SCL that can dissolve in water, when SCL will decompose, then it will break into its constituents ion, that is hydrogen ion and chlorine ion, okay?
Okay.
Yeah, here also they are saying aqueous. In simple understanding I wrote there that which can dissolve in water. Or you can also understand that aqueous means the substance is in solution, okay? Clear?
Clear.
Yes. Also, a little bit property they are explaining. It is important. Important properties are, okay, it is your property. Property. Acid are often produced from non-metallic oxide, okay?
Okay.
Yes. Sulfur oxide. One reaction that I can tell you, acid are often produced from non-metallic oxide. Non-metallic oxide, at any of reaction you can take that one reaction I'm writing. Suppose that carbon dioxide.
Okay.
CO2. Okay. When it will react with non-metallic oxide. CO2 when react with H2O, H2CO3. Or suppose that copper carbonate CuCO3 or sulfur dioxide, that will be much convenient, whatever that you are seeing on your screen, that we can write in the same way.
Okay.
Sulfur oxide SO2 makes a sulfuric acid.
Okay.
So H2, when sulfur dioxide react with water, then it will form H2SO4, okay? Clear?
Yeah.
When sulfur dioxide react with water, sulfur dioxide, it is a non-metallic oxide, non-metal oxide, when react with water forms sulfuric acid, okay?
Okay.
Yes. Do you understand that?
Yeah.
So, now alkalis. When alkalis dissolve in water, produce hydroxide ion, or it is also known as hydroxyl ion, okay?
Yeah.
Yes, it is important. So, you can learn this one. When alkalis dissolve in water, they produce hydroxyl ion. For example, you can take reaction NaOH that is equals to Na plus plus OH minus. So you can see that it is producing OH minus or not. That's yeah. Why it is basic in nature. It is basic.
Oh.
Basic in nature. Okay. Clear?
Yeah.
Yes. Ammonia is slightly different in characteristic. When ammonia react with water, then it form ammonium ion and hydroxyl ion, okay?
Okay.
Understand?
Yeah.
It is important reaction also, beta. And next is bases. A base is chemically opposite to acid, okay? Some bases dissolve in water are called alkalis, but other bases, including many metal oxide, do not dissolve in water, okay?
Okay.
Understand?
Yeah.
Here, that next is your neutralization reaction. Very, very, very important.
Okay.
Very important. Okay. So, neutralization reaction, for your understanding, I can tell you that when I'm writing here, when an acid react with base form when an acid react with base produce salt and water, okay. This process is known as neutralization, okay. Understand? So
yeah.
Reaction that you can write in this way, that word equation, firstly you can write there word equation will be acid plus base will gives salt plus water, okay? So it is your word equation. So it's a reaction, what will be that acid, like when HCl will react with base, that is NaOH, okay? Just here you can see that above I explained that NaOH, yeah, that is your base. Just see that, yeah, basic in nature, okay? So HCl plus NaOH, that will give you, okay, so salt. How you will consider that, what kind of salt it will make? Always remember that H, that will be electropositive, Cl, that is electronegative, sodium, that is electropositive, and OH, that is electronegative, okay?
Okay.
And always positive will combine with negative or not?
Yeah.
So Na plus and Cl minus will combine form NaCl, which is your common salt, and plus H plus and OH minus, it will form H2O, that is your water, okay?
Yeah.
NaCl, that is your common salt. Clear?
Yeah.
So you have to revise all that beta which I explained in your today's class related to chemistry. In a few hours, means within an hour, that your full class, that will be uploaded on my channel. Go to the channel and revise again when you have free time, and don't forget to revise. And please, and please, I am requesting that you should have to like that video if you like that. Okay, as usual, that you understand all that which I explained today to you or not?
Yeah.
Yes, like, post, share, or do you use any type of social networking site like Facebook, Twitter, or something?
No.
Oh, yeah, you are a kid. That's why I'm asking.